First of all, good evening to everyone. And as you said, na, yes, everyone is having a different struggle. So that struggle word, na, that shatters me. Literally, that shatters me. Because the struggle that I have also gone through, na, wo bhi ek, I can't even say, abhi bhi dekho, dekha jaye to for the purpose of class, abhi mere liye bhi struggle hai. Because even I know ki what I am giving, but still abhi jo reach hai na, wo reach pahunchne mein, I guess, bahut time lagne wala hai. Because advertisement, ye wo bahut cheeze, this is kind of struggle. When I was doing my course, I still remember ki mera attempt kab tha, first attempt. In my first attempt, just 4-5 days before the attempt, just 4-5 days before the attempt, it was chicken pox. Chalo, that is gone, wo attempt gaya. Maan liya, theek hai. In second attempt, my mother got diagnosed with the liver cirrhosis. Just jaise mera second attempt tha, she got diagnosed. So we were in the hospital. It was just 1 week before the exam. My third attempt, I was about to just appear for the exam. Ki bas meri exam hai. Again, she was not well. And just, this was next day mera paper hai. And this day at 3 p.m., I'm booking the tickets of the flight ki mujhe unko Delhi leke jaana. Then fourth, again, my brother went into so much of the losses, so much of the lessons, that to cousin, not real brother. But we were having so close connection, it was so much of losses that he will be in insolvent. And he's having a mall. And mall ko manage karna is not easy. So I was there helping him in his insolvency position. My two attempt again, gaya. Again, then it was all about ki bas mera attempt hai, that corona. It is like kitna struggle to, and then finally when it was my attempt, then again I was in typhoid 2 days before the exam. So I can just say ki out of my 8 attempts, 6 were only absent, and I can't even count my attempts, and then finally I cleared that group. So it was like, and to be frank, jab maine group clear kiya tha, maine sare bachcho ko padhate clear kiya tha, main pad rahi hu, main jab se padha rahi. When I was giving my paper, मैं तब से पढ़ा रही हूँ. You find personal tutors?
Yes, ma'am.
Long back, तब मैंने start किया था पढ़ाना, and that time I was earning actually. वो मेरे लिए पढ़ाना कैसा था? He was paying me, and I was earning through that for the treatment of my mother. So it was like कि मैं जो पढ़ रही हूँ, मेरी पढ़ाई सिर्फ वो classes से होती थी कि मैं पढ़ा रही हूँ. और वो जितना मैं पढ़ा रही हूँ वही मेरे लिए मेरा प्रिपरेशन था फॉर IDT, DT, whatever it was. उसके अलावा आई डिडंट गेट टाइम, एंड मेनी टाइम्स इसका के आई नो द लेक्चर्स, इसका के लेक्चर आई हैव रिकॉर्डेड इन हॉस्पिटल. वहां पे भी मैंने आई हैव सेड कि डिस्टर्बेंस होगा बिकॉज आई एम इन हॉस्पिटल, बट स्टिल इसका मुझे भी पढ़ना था, पढ़ाना भी था. दैट वॉज द डेडिकेशन है, तो आप कुछ भी कर सकते हो. एंड वेन आई क्लियर, माई मदर वॉज नॉट देयर टू सी माई रिजल्ट. She was no more at that time. And the struggle we went, ki she was like, Ankita, jis din tu CA banegi na, aisi party dungi. Are you getting? Wo kya feeling hoti hai? So struggle to literally shatters. Wo bolte na, shatter ho jate hain. And that is the reason, wo prefix ab mere liye itna important lagta hi nahi mujhe. Because the person jiske liye mujhe CA banna tha, she has not seen that. उसने देखा ही नहीं. So it is to everyone. जैसे he said ना कि dedication. 3 पे he is coming early in the morning at 3 and he is doing all these things. So at least you are having, you are privileged कि तुम बैठ के पढ़ पा रहे हो. Literally I am having no sibling. There is no sibling. And if I talk about my father, 20 years back, he is missing. He is not even dead. मुझे नहीं पता still he is alive or not alive. Might be someday he might come again. नहीं पता मुझे. He is missing. So when life के बोलते हैं ना, जब फटके पड़ते हैं तो ऐसे भी पढ़ सकते हैं, तो you are in a very good position. कि तुम लोग अभी बहुत आराम से निकाल रहे हो चीजें, तो stop complaining about that. Students मेरे को complain करते कि मैम ये दिक्कत हो गई, breakup हो गया and my mind is shattered. अरे भैया, breakup तुम्हें पता भी है क्या breakup होता है? अभी कौन से टू बी वेरी फ्रेंक निब्बा निब्बी लगते फिर मेरे को. ये एक ऑनेस्टली वेरी ब्रिलियंट स्टूडेंट, जस्ट बिकॉज किसी और ने एग्जाम नहीं दी, उसने भी एग्जाम नहीं दी कि उसका छूट रहा है. अरे भाई, सीए कर रहे हो तुम, ये कौन से वचन निभा रहे हो साथ में कि इसके साथ ही चलेंगे, व्हाट इज दिस? आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड द फीलिंग्स, बट ये जो सिंसियरिटी होती है ना पेपर की, दैट इज एट अ डिफरेंट लेवल. सो अंडरस्टैंड दैट सिंसियरिटी ऑल्सो. ओके, सो आई वुड जस्ट से एवरी वन की अभी जो टाइम मिल रहा है ना इतना यूज कर लो एंड स्टॉप कंप्लेनिंग कि ये नहीं हो वो नहीं हो. आज ही एक बच्चे से बात हुई, मैम सिंस मई 2016 मेरा अटेम्प्ट था. कब से? उसने बोला मई 2016 से अटेम्प्ट था, मैं क्लियर नहीं कर पा रही. व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड आस्किंग हर द क्वेश्चंस कि सप्लाई का ये बताओ, मुझे डीटी का ये बताओ, इक्वलाइजेशन एंड व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम विद दैट अप्रोच, करेक्ट अप्रोच नहीं, क्लासेस सब हो गई, अप्रोच करेक्ट नहीं है एंड वी ब्लेम कि आईसीआई फेल करता है. सो एवरी टाइम इफ यू हैव दिस प्रिविलेज, थोड़ा सा यूटिलाइज करो, थोड़ा सा एफर्ट्स लगाओ. आज नहीं तो कल यू विल गेट द रिजल्ट. एंड आई लिटरली से स्टॉप बीइंग रिजल्ट ओरिएंटेड. तुम बस अपनी प्रोसेस पे ध्यान दे दो, कभी ना कभी वो रिजल्ट सामने आ जाएगा. एज आई से ना ऑलवेज, कर्म पे फोकस करो, ठीक है, रिजल्ट तुम्हें फल हमेशा मिल ही जाएगा, यू विल गेट दैट. ठीक है, चलो. सो अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग विथ अ छोटा मोटा मोटिवेशन वट वी वर एबल टू डू. ठीक है, अब तो बहुत अच्छा पढ़ के दिखाएंगे मैम. अभी तो दिया है आपने, थोड़ी देर तक तो रहता है वो हमारे दिमाग में, उसके बाद जाता है. चलो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई. मैम सप्लाई का जो डेफिनेशन किया था, वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सप्लाई एंड इन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सप्लाई अभी तक हमको इतना तो समझ में आ गया कार्तिक की नॉट डेट कार्तिक कार्तिक नायडू कीप योर वीडियो ऑन. So someone is Naidu here. Keep your videos on.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, his video should be on.
Actually, I'm in study hall, ma'am. I have so many friends and they are talking with me.
Doesn't matter. Keep yourself on mute and you can keep the video on. That is it.
Okay, ma'am.
You can keep yourself on mute.
Okay, ma'am.
चलो तो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद सप्लाई. मैम सप्लाई हमने कब स्टार्ट किया था? वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद सप्लाई ऑन 5th of December. 5th of December को अ डेफिनेशन, द डेफिनेशन वॉज सप्लाई, दैट वॉज आई फॉरगॉट विच सेक्शन इट वॉज. सप्लाई का डेफिनेशन अंडर विच सेक्शन?
7.
तो इन सेक्शन नंबर 7 वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सप्लाई एंड हैव आई मेंशन दिस थिंग that supply is what? Taxable event of GST. Have I mentioned this many times ki supply is nothing but the taxable event of GST. GST ka taxable event kya hai? GST ka taxable event is supply. That I have mentioned. That means, ma'am, first of all, we have moved to section number 7 just to understand whether a particular transaction is supply or not. Then if it is supply, either it would be supply of goods or supply of service. And my schedule number 2 mentioned ki ye supply of goods hai or it is supply of service. Remember that we have done. Ma'am, after considering yes, it is supply, humko ye date pata karni hai. We want to know ki ye taxable event, that is supply, actually kab hua. Ma'am, I am not understanding actually kab hua ka kya matlab samjhe. What do you mean by actually when supply happened? What do you mean by that? To understand one thing. Sabse pehle, suppose this is a person. This is a person. He want to purchase something. Suppose I want to purchase something. So what I will do? Sabse pehle, I made a call. I made a telephonic conversation with that person. Ki, tell me what are the features. Tell me when it will be available. It is, can I say it is just I want information, nothing. Can I say it is the first step towards a supply? Ki at least the person would want certain information. Ki bhai mujhe information to do ki what is your product is all about. Then he will order, that is booking done. He will book, ki book that thing for me. This is suppose booking ke liye he called me when he called me on today. That is 19th of December ko he called me ki please book that. Please usko book kar do. I said please give us advance. okay, we will book, but we want advance. So suppose on 25th of December, he had given me advance. So ma'am, advance ab mila mujhe. Then suppose after giving advance on 25th December, on 31st December, I have moved that order. Remember, we have done place of supply mein movement. So we have done what? Movement of the order. Kartik Naidu, you have not attended my previous class, so might be you will find something difficult that you have not done the linkage. Abhi 10-12 linkage you have not done. These were 10 to 12 classes you have missed. Okay? So try to catch up a little bit. So can I say this person first of all called me a different day. 1st December ko he called me. Then booking done on 19th December. He has given me advance on 25th December. Then I have started movement of goods from Maharashtra. I am sending the goods to Tamil Nadu. Suppose he is the person from Tamil Nadu. I am giving it. I am initiating the movement of goods on 31st December. So ma'am, we are confused. Whether we should deem that supply done here, whether we should deem supply is already done when you have started booking, or it is when you have given advance, or it is when movement initiated. And ma'am, after even the movement of the goods, that goods reached on 2nd January. 2nd January, that goods reached. Are you getting what is the problem? Supply hua kab? When is the supply? Just a minute. Huh? Sure. So are you understanding problem kya hai? Ki actually, when is my supply? Actually, when is my supply? Is it on 2nd of January? Is it on my 31st January? Is it happening when he has given advance, or when we have done booking, or when it is telephonic conversation? Bhai, hai kab? When it is? Are you getting? So for that problem, solution, time of supply ka concept was initiated. Understood? Have you understood the problem? Ki problem kya hai? So for that purpose, time of supply came to now. For understanding time of supply, you cannot go thoroughly only with the time of supply ke concept. Sirf tum time of supply ke concept se time of supply ko nahi samajh paoge. You won't be able to understand concept of time of supply only by applying section 12 and section 13. Ma'am, what is section 12 and what is section 13? Entire time of supply ke formula they have given in section number 12 with respect to goods, and section number 13 when it is supply of service. But if I want to apply this time of supply ka concept, I should know one thing, that is when finally an invoice should be generated. There is a concept when invoice should be generated. Now, why we should know that concept ki when an invoice should be generated to understand. See, suppose abhi we do not know anything about time of supply, but isko dekh ke kya lag raha hai, ma'am? If the time of supply with respect to goods have been given. If time of supply with respect to goods, suppose ma'am, goods ka forward charge hai. Goods ka kya hai mera? Forward charge. That means no reverse charge concept is there. Forward charge mein normally what is time of supply? Yahan likha hai invoice or due date of invoice, whichever is earlier. Date of invoice or due date of invoice, whichever is earlier. Now the concept is, I don't know what would be the exact due date of invoice. Due date ka matlab kya hai? Kab tak tumhara invoice generate ho jana chahiye? At least this is the date, at least this date tak tumhara invoice should get generated. Are you understanding? At least till this date your invoice should get generated. Ab either you have generated the invoice or the due date of invoice, whichever is earlier. समझो अब इसको एक एग्जाम्पल से लेते हैं. सपोज लूप होल को थोड़ा सा पहले डिस्कस करते हैं. वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिस्कस द लूप होल. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड वन थिंग, मुझे एक चीज पता है दैट इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट गुड्स एंड यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई विद रिस्पेक्ट टू गुड अंडर फॉरवर्ड चार्ज मैकेनिज्म, मुझे सिर्फ इतना समझ में आ रहा है कि इफ इनवॉइस इज नॉट जनरेटेड तो टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई नहीं हो पाएगा. व्हाई? इनवॉइस और ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस व्हिचएवर इज अर्लियर. तो आर यू गेटिंग द गेम प्लेज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू इनवॉइस ओनली. इफ आई डू नॉट जनरेट इनवॉइस पर्पसली, मैं अगर इनवॉइस ही जनरेट नहीं करूं तो टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई नहीं आएगा. टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई नहीं आएगा तो टैक्सेबल इवेंट नहीं होगा. इफ आई डू नॉट जनरेट इनवॉइस देयर विल बी नो टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई. नो टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई मीन्स नो टैक्सेबल event and no taxable event means I am not liable to pay GST. Are you getting? Can I drag kar sakti hu? Ki nahi karna generate invoice. Bhai tu leke ja. I am not generating invoice. Suppose I have sold this mobile to some person. Nahi generate karna invoice. Forward mechanism hai. I am not generating invoice. Kyun generate nahi kar rahe? If I generate invoice, there will be taxable event. There will be supply, there will be time of supply. So I'm dragging. नहीं करना invoice generate तो taxable event नहीं आएगा. Taxable event नहीं आएगा तो liable to pay GST भी नहीं होंगे. Understand? Once you have identified कि supply है, that means definition section number 7. Then we have identified, remember, through place of supply, whether it is inter or intra. Correct? After identifying supply, inter, intra, now when actually supply किस date को हुआ? Because the date when supply happened, that is your time of supply. तो third concept जो supply के साथ जुड़ता है, that is what? Time of supply. Are you getting why time of supply important समझ में है? कि वो date बताएगा. अब suppose you are not generating invoice. Government को भी तो पता है you will utilize this loophole. तुम drag करोगे, तुम invoice generate नहीं करोगे. हमको पता है ये चीज. We know in order to utilize the loophole, you will not generate the invoice. In such a case, they have introduced ये due date of invoice है. Due date of invoice. This is the due date of invoice. At least till this date, your invoice should get generated. Are you getting? तो उन्होंने क्या कर दिया? एक date fix कर दी. कि एटलीस्ट टिल हैपनिंग ऑफ दिस इवेंट, जब ये इवेंट होगा एटलीस्ट टिल दैट टाइम योर इनवॉइस शुड गेट जनरेटेड. तो उन्होंने क्या कर दिया? एक बेंचमार्क दे दिया कि इसके बाद नहीं, यहाँ तक तो जनरेट हो जाना चाहिए. दैट इज द ड्यू डेट. एंड आर यू गेटिंग? आई शुड नो व्हाट इज द ड्यू डेट अंडर वेरियस सर्कमस्टेंस. तो ये कहाँ लिखा है मैम ड्यू डेट का कॉन्सेप्ट? दिस इज नॉट गिवन इन टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई. नाउ दिस इज गिवन इन मॉड्यूल नंबर 2 का. देयर इज अ चैप्टर इनवॉइस डेबिट क्रेडिट नोट. मॉड्यूल नंबर 2 ICAI के अकॉर्डिंग यू हैव चैप्टर इनवॉइस डेबिट क्रेडिट नोट. एंड इन दैट इनवॉइस सेक्शन नंबर 31 इट हैज बीन गिवन. इन दैट इनवॉइस ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस सेक्शन नंबर 13 गिवन. सेक्शन नंबर 31 विल टेल यू कि वो ड्यू डेट क्या होती है. आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? तो कैन आई से कि प्योरली टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई का लिंकेज किधर जाता है? द टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई हैज लिंकेज विद सेक्शन नंबर 31 ऑफ इनवॉइस चैप्टर. Without that section number 31, you cannot apply time of supply chapter, whether in case of goods or whether in case of service. Understood? Up, now I am coming to what is that section number 31? So this is the time of supply, section 12, section 13. And for that, we should know what is the due date for generating the invoice. That is, ma'am, you are saying section number 31. So where is that section number 31? This is my section number 31. And this you will find where? In invoice debit credit note chapter, where? Module number 2 of ICAI. Ab bahut easy hai. It is very easy. Actually, it is very easy. If I talk about again this goods, I am talking about goods and I am talking about service. Ab whether you supply goods or whether you supply service, invoice to you will generate, right? Whether it is supply of goods or whether it is supply of service, goods will be or will be a service, invoice to generate hoga. But let us bifurcate. Ma'am, might be it is what? my normal supply or might be it is my continuous supply. अब थोड़ा सा समझना. If I try to divide time of supply, if I try to bifurcate time of supply, तो मैम टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई के लिए देयर शुड बी सप्लाई, राइट? टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई जानने के लिए सबसे पहले कोई चीज सप्लाई भी तो होनी चाहिए. रिमेंबर वी हैव डन इन लास्ट क्लासेस कि हो सकता है शेड्यूल नंबर 3 में इट इज कवर्ड, तो इट इज नाइदर सप्लाई ऑफ गुड नॉर सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस. सो फॉर अप्लाइंग द टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई के कॉन्सेप्ट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट शुड बी सप्लाई. मैम नाउ सप्लाई कुड बी ऑफ गुड्स ऑल्सो, सप्लाई कुड बी ऑफ सर्विस ऑल्सो. इट कुड बी सप्लाई ऑफ गुड, इट कुड बी सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस. मैम इन केस ऑफ गुड्स इट कुड बी नॉर्मल सप्लाई और इट कुड बी अप्रूवल बेसिस का सप्लाई, सप्लाई ऑन अप्रूवल बेसिस. मैम इवन इन केस ऑफ नॉर्मल सप्लाई इट कुड बी अ कंटिन्यूस सप्लाई और इट कुड बी अ नॉन कंटिन्यूस सप्लाई. अच्छा मैम आर वी गोइंग अगेन इन टू द डेप्थ ऑफ टाइप्स ऑफ सप्लाई? सप्लाई आइदर इट कुड बी ऑफ गुड्स और इट कुड बी ऑफ सर्विस. डन. If it is goods, it could be forward, it could be reverse also, it could be continuous also, it could be not a continuous supply, it could be normal supply, it could be approval basis ka supply. Abhi kya aega? Bifurcation going on. Understanding? So, har bifurcation ke liye they have given due date kya ho? For every bifurcation, first of all, they have given what will be the due date. Yahan tak tumhara invoice generate hona compulsory hai. That should be generated. So let us start with this. Sabse pehle, when it is ma'am normal supply, ma'am what do you mean by normal supply and what do you mean by this approval basis supply? What do you mean by normal supply and what do you mean by approval basis supply? Then we will go into the detail of continuous and not continuous. Pehle ye to batao ki approval, ye normal supply kya hai and what is approval basis supply. You come to my shop. तुम कहाँ है मेरी शॉप पे आए. यू वॉन्ट टू परचेस अगेन माई मोबाइल. सिंपली आई हैव गिवन यू मोबाइल एंड आई हैव टेकन व्हाट मनी फ्रॉम यू. सप्लाई डन. तो आई हैव गिवन यू मोबाइल, आई हैव टेकन मनी, सप्लाई डन. दिस इज नॉर्मल सप्लाई. बट नाउ मैम व्हाट इज अप्रूवल बेसिस सप्लाई? सपोज यू आर ऑल्सो अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर. तुम अच्छे बड़े लेवल पे काम करते हो. आई एम ऑल्सो वर्किंग एट अ वेरी बिग लेवल. You are also working at a big level. I am also working at a big level. तुम call करते हो मुझे, बोलते please send us the sample. At least मुझे क्या दो, sample दो. If we are okay with the sample, then we will do further order. फिर हम further order करेंगे. तो suppose big level है, तो 10,000 units I have send you as a sample. किसी भी particular चीज की 10,000 unit I have send you as a sample. कि if you like, okay. If you do not like, return it back to me. तो यू विल गिव द अप्रूवल वेदर यू लाइक और वेदर यू डू नॉट लाइक. तुम अप्रूव कर देना, मुझे सेंड कर देना. अगर अप्रूवल नहीं जमा, मेरे क्लॉथ्स हैं या फिर वॉट एवर यूनिट आई एम सेंडिंग नहीं जमा, रिटर्न इट बैक टू मी. एंड इफ इट इज ओके तो आप क्या बोल देना, ओके अप्रूव्ड. तो 10,000 तो तुम्हारा सेल हो ही गया वहां पे. ही हैज अप्रूव्ड, तो 10,000 यूनिट्स तो ऑलरेडी सोल्ड. बाकी का जितना भी यू विल गिव अस द ऑर्डर, हम उसको और सेंड कर देंगे. इसको अब एक बार और समझ लेते हैं. व्हाट इज मैम अप्रूवल बेसिस? सपोज दिस इज द गुड्स. सपोज ऑन अप्रूवल बेसिस दिस इज नथिंग, दिस इज माय गुड्स, गुड 1, 2, 3, 4, ठीक है. ये मेरे क्या है, गुड्स है. नाउ आई एम द मैन्युफैक्चरर ऑफ दिस गुड्स. नाउ यू एज द डीलर, तुम कौन हो एज अ डीलर? तुमने मुझे क्या बोला, यू हैव ऑर्डर्ड मी. क्या ऑर्डर किया मुझे, कि प्लीज सेंड सम सैंपल्स, मुझे कुछ सैंपल दे दो फॉर अप्रूवल. तो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग, मैंने क्या किया, एक पर्टिकुलर का क्या दे दिया, सैंपल इसको सेंड कर दिया. मैंने क्या किया, पर्टिकुलर सैंपल उसको क्या कर दिया, सेंड कर दिया. अंडरस्टूड इतना? नाउ दिस पर्सन विल चेक. ये पर्सन क्या करेगा, चेक करेगा. दिस पर्सन विल चेक इट. आफ्टर चेकिंग आइदर ही विल से यस और ही विल से नो. चेक करने के बाद आइदर ही विल से यस और ही विल से नो. If he says yes, तो ये यूनिट सपोज इस पर्टिकुलर के 10,000 यूनिट मैंने ऑलरेडी उसको दे दिए. कितना, 10,000. तो इफ ही से यस तो कहना है 10,000 का तो सप्लाई ऑलरेडी डन. 10,000 का सप्लाई ऑलरेडी done. Why? Because he has approved na, ki I liked it. Ma'am, if say no, to what you will do? You will return that goods to him. So can I say this is sale on approval? This is what? Sale on approval. Any doubt on what is approval basis ka sale? Understood everyone? So, ma'am, if you are sending the goods on approval, kitna wait kar loge? I am giving you the goods on approval. Ki okay, you approve, phir mujhe batana. So how much time I will wait? 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, 4 month, kitna? Are you getting? If I am sending the goods for approval, if I am sending the goods for approval, to kitna wait karna hai total? To GST ka bolta hai, law says only for 6 months we will say ki ye approval ke liye. Ma'am, if 6 month mein the person has not sent me the goods back, usne mujhe mere goods wapis nahi bheje, so we will wait for 6 months. Kitna we will wait? We will wait for 6 months. What if within 6 months he doesn't return me the goods back? Deemed as supply. After 6 months, हम मान लेंगे कि it is supply. So are you getting? तो वो time of supply क्या होगा? तो understand one thing. Now this is the goods that I have sent on approval. ठीक है? Suppose this is the goods sent on 1st April. मैंने 1st April को ये goods क्या किए थे? Approval basis पे किसी person को send किए थे. As per GST law, kitna time to maximum we will assume ki it is on approval? 6 months. So can I say April, May, June, July, August, September, 30th September tak we will say ki yes, it is on approval. But once it is 1st of October, if the person has not returned you the goods back, it is supply. Supply ho chuka hai because 6 months are enough for an approval. Are you getting? Ma'am, what will happen if on 15 July, the person says yes. So either 6 months from date, either 6 months from date of removal or actual approval, whichever is earlier, that will be your invoice ka date. At least tab tak tumhara kya generate ho jana chahiye? Invoice should get generated because this is your time of supply. Understood? Bhai, seedhi baat hai, approval ke liye bhej rahe ho, we will wait for 6 months. 6 months ke baad kitna sochoge? Itna kutna vichar karna hai tumko? How much you have to think ki after 6 months also you are thinking ki we should purchase or not purchase? Either within 6 months say yes or no, and after 6 months it is what? At least invoice ban jana chahiye. हाँ हो सकता है विद 6 month के phase में ही he says yes or no, तो that date you have to take. तो can I say this यहाँ पे कि ma'am in case of approval basis 6 months from the date of approval or the time of supply, that means when he accepted, तो accept किया मतलब उसने purchase किया, whichever is earlier, that is what section 31 के according, at least whichever is earlier invoice should get generated. यहाँ पे तुम्हारा इनवॉइस जनरेट हो जाना चाहिए. नाउ राइट डाउन अप्रूवल बेसिस, बिना देखे इतना सा लिख लो कि व्हाट इज द रूल फॉर दैट अप्रूवल बेसिस. डोंट चेक इट, जस्ट राइट इट डाउन.
Ma'am, no voice.
Done? So basically, approval is what? 6 months from the date of removal. Why they have written 6 months from the date of removal? Are when he was sending the goods for approval, it was just a removal. Supply nahi hua tha. No consideration was there. Are you getting? Na koi consideration tha, kuch nahi tha. Just for the purpose of approval, I have sended you. Therefore, it is 6 months from date of removal. Ma'am, I have removed my goods on 1st April. So 6 months from the date of removal, that is 30th September. Or time of supply. Ma'am, what is time of supply? When he accepted. So ma'am, in our example, 15 July ko he accepted. So whichever is earlier, ma'am, 15 July is earlier. That means that 15 July already your supply done. Your invoice should get generated at least till 15 July to generate hoi jana chahiye tha. And that date you are liable to pay GST. Because taxable event happened and on 15 July you are liable to pay GST. Understood? Now, this is with respect to approval done. Ye wala hamara kaam kya tha? This was with respect to approval and that we have done. Ye ho gaya hamara approval wala kaam done. Now, coming to next segment, that is ma'am, what is normal supply? Ma'am, normal supply kya hoga? So when it comes to normal supply, I have given you the goods and taken consideration from you. I have given you the goods, taken consideration from you, but in that case also, do cheeze possible hai. Two options are possible. What are the two options? Either it would be a continuous supply or it would be other than continuous supply. Ma'am, in other than continuous supply, either there will be movement of goods or there will be no movement of goods. Re baba re. Section 31, invoice kab tak generate ho jana chahiye, till what time invoice should get generated, first thing done, approval basis. Now, normal goods, normal supply further divided into continuous and other than continuous. Then my continuous and other than continuous, mein, other than continuous further divided into with movement or without movement. And if you have done place of supply properly, now you would understand ki what is movement and what is not a movement. So, ma'am, when it is what? So, in my example, now they are saying about normal supply. Ma'am, I am focusing first of all on normal supply further divided into continuous. Yes. Normal supply divided into other. Then continuous. So normal is divided into continuous and other than continuous it has been divided. And then other than continuous further divided into movement. Further divided into movement and divided into no movement. Now, ma'am, ek baar ye movement and no movement bhi samajh le kya? What is movement and no movement? Ma'am, it is supply of goods with movement and it is supply of goods with no movement. So ma'am, with movement, if the supply is, suppose I am where in Pune, don't suppose, I am actually in Pune. So I am in Pune, I am ordering something. Maine kya kiya? Kuch order kiya. I am in Pune. From Pune, I order. Maine kya kiya? Order kiya Pune se. And from where the goods are coming? From Indore. Indore se goods aa rahe hai and I have ordered from Pune. So ma'am, from Indore that goods will be coming to Pune. Can I say yes? This is nothing but this is movement of goods. This is nothing but this is what? Movement of goods. Ma'am, when there is no movement, suppose this is my mall. Ye kya mall hai? Either we go to the mall, whatever we want to purchase, here is the person, bill wala person. He will give you whatever you have purchased and you will give him what consideration, right? Ma'am, no movement. Jahan gaye, shopkeeper ke paas gaye, wahi we got the goods and wahi pe humne consideration pay kiya. There is no movement of goods. Are you understanding what is movement of goods when from one place to another place goods are moving? And jahan pe consideration diya, wahi tumko goods mil gaye, that means there is no movement of goods. Ab, ma'am, in our case when there is movement of goods, invoice kab tak generate ho jana chahiye? So in case when there is movement of goods, so your invoice should get generated at least movement ke pehle. whenever you are going to initiate the movement, jab bhi tum initiate kar rahe ho movement, at least before or on that date of removal, tab tak to invoice generate kar do. So this is what, if it is what movement of goods, so at least generate your invoice before the removal of such goods, tab to invoice de do. So that is due date for invoice in case movement of goods is there. Agar movement of goods hai, due date of invoice is what? This. मैम देर इज नो मूवमेंट ऑफ गुड्स, तो मैम डिलीवर तो हो गया ना कहीं पे, तो डिलीवर हो रहा होगा, तो ऑन और बिफोर द डिलीवरी ऑफ गुड्स, ऑन और बिफोर द डिलीवरी ऑफ सच गुड्स एटलीस्ट. तब मैम इन माय एग्जांपल वी वेंट टू द मॉल, हम मॉल गए थे एंड दैट मॉल वाला पर्सन वॉज गिविंग अस द गुड्स, तो एटलीस्ट बिफोर गिविंग द गुड्स और एट द टाइम ऑफ गिविंग द गुड्स, डिलीवरिंग द गुड्स, उसको इनवॉइस बोलो ना जनरेट करें, दैट इज नथिंग बट योर ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस. इतना समझ में आया? Can I say it was approval basis? Yes. Can I say there is movement basis? Ma'am, movement mein bhi come to know on or before the removal. On or before the date of removal. Right? Ma'am, if it is no movement, on or before the date when you are delivering the goods, deliver karne se pehle to at least generate the invoice. Itni baat samajh mein aayi? Ab ma'am, isme ek cheez aur likhiye. One more thing that has been written over here, wo aapne nahi padha. What is that? Ma'am, if you carefully look here, on or before the delivery, samajh mein aaya, before delivery or on the date when you are delivering, you should generate the invoice. But yahan aur bhi kuch likha hai, making the goods available. Ma'am, is it same, delivery and making the goods available, is it same? Kya ye same hai? So my answer is no, they are not same. Now again, we are taking the example. This is nothing. This is a car. Okay. This is nothing, but this is a car. Okay. This is a car. Now you went to the showroom. Obviously, for the car you have to go to the showroom. ठीक है, so this is the person who went to the showroom to purchase what? To purchase car. Done? इतना समझ में आया? This person went to the showroom for the purchase of what? Car. Now this showroom owner, ये showroom वाला क्या बोलेगा? This person says I want white color का car. ठीक है, I want what? White color का car. And this is let's say Mercedes. उसको कौन सी चाहिए? White color चाहिए. Is white color का car available right now? Yes ma'am, white color का car is right now available. अभी क्या है? We have white color का car that is available. He says yellow. This is the check and give me the car. So is there any movement of goods? No. जहां आए वहीं की वहीं, no movement of goods. As well as, is the goods delivered? Yes ma'am, delivery done. So on or before the delivery of the goods. On before delivery of goods, invoice should get generated. इतनी बात समझ में आ गई? Everyone done? Now my second thing. Again, this person, he is coming for the purchase of car. This was my person number one. Now suppose another person, that is person number two, he comes for the purchase of car. What he wants? He also wants Mercedes. उसको भी क्या चाहिए थी? Mercedes. But he loves golden very much. उसको क्या चाहिए? Golden color बहुत ही पसंद है, बहुत ही. He loves golden very much. So what he wants? Instead of white, he want golden color. So golden is a very limited edition. You cannot find कि एकदम तुम्हारे showroom पे रहेगा. It is not the case. Golden is a very limited edition. So now what this shopkeeper will say? Showroom owner will say, right now we are not having the golden. Right now, we are not having golden car in our collection. Wait for at least 15 days. Just give us some advance and we will make it available for you. Are you getting the word? We will make it available for you. So when you make it available for that person, so can I say at least on the date when you make it available, either you will deliver right now or when you will be making it available for that person on or before the date when you make that thing available for person, invoice should be generated. So can I say delivery word is used for present and make it available is used when in future you are making the thing available. So on or before that date, you should what? Generate invoice. So ma'am, abhi tak humne kitna kiya? How much we have done? Point number one, we have done invoice, due date of invoice given in section number 31. Due date of invoice that is given in section number 31. Ma'am, when it was supply of goods, in supply of goods, when it was approval basis. So ma'am, 6 months from the date of approval or time of supply, whichever is earlier. Done. Then here, after that we have again, ma'am, it was supply of goods. Yes, supply of goods. Ma'am, it is normal supply and normal is further divided into continuous and other than continuous. Ma'am, when it is other than continuous, further divided into movement and no movement. Ma'am, movement hai, so on or before the removal, you should generate invoice. Ma'am, there is no movement on or before making the goods available or delivery of goods. You should generate the invoice. Understood? Ab, iske baad, again, we are coming to which point? Ma'am, what about continuous supply of goods? Ma'am, kab hota hai continuous supply? You purchase bulk mein 1 lakh unit and say every month deliver us 10,000, 10,000, 10,000. So bulk mein you have given me the order ki 1 lakh unit I want. And every month keep sending 10,000, 10,000, 10,000, 10,000. So can I say yes, it is continuous supply of goods? It is what? Monthly continuous supply of goods. Ab mujhe ek cheez batao, if it is continuous supply of goods, either I will send you, you will be giving me successive payment. Jaise jaise payment hoga, at least tab to main invoice generate kar do. If it is not payment, I will give you something till that itna event ho gaya, so you should give me this. So are you getting? Successive kuch to hoga na, either it would be successive account statement you will be giving me, either it will be your successive payment. So ya to tum jab account statement bana rahe ho ya phir jab successive payment receive karo usse pehle invoice generate kar do na. Either successive payment or it is in it is what? Account statement. Are bhai, jab you do the accounting sale karte ho to you write na ledger, sales purchase ka ledger. So accounting करते रहते हैं ना तो either I will be giving देखो for this month इतना I have transferred to you इतना I have goods transferred to you so either you will be giving successive account if not successive account it would be you will be receiving successive payment कुछ तो होगा successive तो whatever is the successive on or before that day invoice generate कर दो so this is your goods so again गुड्स के रिस्पेक्ट में अभी तक हमने क्या देखा इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ गुड्स इट इज व्हाट इफ इट इज मैम सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स द सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स कुड बी मैम नॉर्मल और मैम सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स कुड बी रिमूवल बेसिस अप्रूवल बेसिस नॉट रिमूवल इट वुड बी व्हाट अप्रूवल बेसिस मैम व्हेन इट कम्स टू नॉर्मल इट कुड बी आइदर कंटिन्यूअस और इट कुड नॉट बी कंटिन्यूअस Ma'am, if not continuous, further divided into movement and further divided into no movement. Ma'am, continuous mein either we will check successive account statement or we will check successive. F, S stands for successive. Successive payment we will be receiving. So on or before that date, section number 31. Arre bhai, invoice generate kar do. Ma'am, if it is movement on or before the removal of that goods. Ma'am, if it is no removal on or before delivery or making the goods deliver, making the goods available. Ma'am, if it is approval 6 months from the date of removal or time of supply, whichever is earlier. Then it comes section number 31 that tells you about due date of invoice. Due date of invoice. Then this due date ka concept you will apply to time of supply. Giving you 2 minutes, write down this chart without looking to the PDF. Mat dekho PDF and try to write it down. Done.
Done, ma'am.
So basically, we have not yet moved to time of supply. This is just due date kya hogi, till that due date you should generate the invoice. You cannot delay the generation of invoice ki delay kar denge to time of supply nahi aayega, aisa nahi hai. Specifically section number 31, what is the due date that you should generate your invoice? And have we done only with respect to goods? Abhi to sirf goods hua hai. Now going to service. Ma'am, is it possible service mein approval basis kuch hoga kya? Is that possible? कि मैम सर्विस में अप्रूवल बेसिस कुछ होगा? सर्विस में यस अप्रूवल बेसिस होता है, बट फॉर दिस जीएसटी वो इतना डिटेल में गई नहीं. दे हैव नॉट गॉन इन टू डिटेल. कैसे बोल रही हूँ मैं समझो. चेक दिस चार्ट. अगर मैं इस चार्ट की बात करूँ तो वॉट यू विल फाइंड इन केस ऑफ सर्विस ओनली टू बाइफर्केशन, कंटिन्यूस अदर देन कंटिन्यूस. सिर्फ सिंपल है. आइदर इट वुड बी कंटिन्यूस सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस और इट वुड नॉट बी अ कंटिन्यूस सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस. मैम हाउ अप्रूवल बेसिस इज पॉसिबल इन केस ऑफ सर्विस एंड व्हाई दे हैव नॉट टेकन इट? अब दोनों चीजें समझनी पड़ेगी ना मैम. इज दैट पॉसिबल कि अप्रूवल बेसिस इज देयर इन सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस ऑल्सो? एंड अगर वो अप्रूवल बेसिस सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस में पॉसिबल होता है तो व्हाई दे हैव नॉट टेकन? And if they have not taken, तो कोई logic है क्या? तो समझो. When I talk about service on approval basis, remember before the starting of the class, at least I guess 5 days or 3 days demo I have provided. Demo provided, approval basis. If you like it, say yes. If you do not like it, that is okay. So that is what service on approval ही तो था कि either in 5 days you have to approve or you can say कि no. I want to discontinue. That was 5 days. But ma'am, why you are not considering it as a supply? क्यों supply नहीं बोल रहे? Listen to me properly. Ma'am, supply of service था वो. Approval था. Was there any consideration? No, ma'am, there was no consideration. And if you remember, if something is without consideration, what we have discussed, always check schedule number 1. And schedule number 1 में anywhere it is mentioned. कि डोमेस्टिक सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस कहीं पे ऐसा मेंशन है कि सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस? हमने समझा था शेड्यूल नंबर 1 हैज परमानेंट ट्रांसफर ऑफ बिजनेस एसेट. तो मैम इट वाज बिजनेस एसेट, इट वाज गुड्स, इट वाज नॉट सर्विस. देन वी हैव डिस्कस मैम एजेंट टू प्रिंसिपल ट्रांसफर. तो आई एम नॉट योर एजेंट, यू आर नॉट माई प्रिंसिपल, तो वो भी फॉलो नहीं होता. मैम वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस इम्पोर्ट ऑफ सर्विस. तो इम्पोर्ट ऑफ सर्विस तो कंट्री अलग हो गया. So then also it is not falling. Then what we have also discussed, distinct person and related party. Are you my distinct person? Are you my related party? So any of the criteria of schedule 1 to follow in your ma'am. So when without consideration, you are not falling under schedule number 1 also. So it is not at all a supply. When something is not at all a supply, so yahan pe approval basis ka tangible fact to kuch hai nahi. अप्रूवल बेसिस का कुछ भी क्या है, टेंजिबल फैक्ट नहीं है. बट मैम व्हाट अबाउट गुड्स? गुड्स में भी तो देयर वाज नो कंसीडरेशन. गुड्स पे था, गुड्स सेंट ऑन अप्रूवल बेसिस. व्हेन आई सेंड यू द गुड्स ऑन अप्रूवल बेसिस, मैंने तुमको गुड्स दिए फॉर द अप्रूवल बेसिस. मैम वहां भी तो कंसिडरेशन नहीं था. देयर वॉज कंसिडरेशन मिसिंग, राइट? मिसिंग क्या था? कंसिडरेशन था मैम. कंसिडरेशन वॉज मिसिंग एंड देट वॉज ऑल्सो नॉट फॉलिंग विद इन माई शेड्यूल नंबर 1. Then why goods में approval basis taken? Because goods में there was movement of goods. Goods का movement हो रहा था. And because of movement of goods, वहां तो tracking is needed ना. E-way bill भी वो generate करवाते हैं. तो in that case, it was very much needed. There was movement of goods, so we need tracking. So if 6 months elapsed and your goods have not yet returned back, तुम्हारा 6 महीना हो गया and still your goods not returned back. Something is fishy over here. क्यों 6 months में you have given 6 months का approval? After 6 months also goods are not returning to you. So this is deemed supply. This is deemed supply. After 6 months this is your deemed supply. So are you getting why in service not possible? Service में I am not giving something that could return back. अरे I have given you classes, 5 days demo I have given. Can you return me back that demo? रिटर्न भी कर सकते हो? इज दैट पॉसिबल कि मैम नो आपका नॉलेज वापस रख लो? इज दैट पॉसिबल? बट गुड्स में तो इट इज पॉसिबल ना. सो फॉर दैट फैक्ट अप्रूवल बेस इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन सर्विस, बट इट वॉज पॉसिबल इन गुड्स एंड लूपहोल वॉज देयर इन गुड्स सेंट ऑन अप्रूवल बेसिस. देयरफॉर स्पेसिफिकली ड्यू डेट कहाँ पे इंक्लूड किया? इन केस ऑफ गुड्स. अंडरस्टूड दिस लॉजिक एवरीवन? कार्तिक आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? बोथ द कार्तिक आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग?
यस मैम.
ठीक है कार्तिक, व्हाट इज योर सरनेम? नॉट नायडू वाला दैट कार्तिक?
नो सरनेम कार्तिक सुब्रमण्य.
ओके सो आई विल कॉल यू नायडू. ठीक है दैट विल बी इजी फॉर मी. चलो सो दिस इज व्हाट सर्विस. अब सर्विस में मैम आइदर इट कुड बी कंटिन्यूअस सर्विस और इट कुड नॉट बी अ कंटिन्यूअस सर्विस. मैम कंटिन्यूअस सर्विस कैसे? I have taken fees from you. Can I say ki just I have taken fees from you and that service is complete? भाई तुम तो negative publicity कर कर के मार दोगे फिर मुझे. If I have taken money from you और मैंने कहा बस money ले लिया demo दे दिए बात खत्म, is that so? No. After taking fees from you, it is continuous 60 days का service I am providing. That is a continuous service. So are you getting continuous? मैम टेलीकम्युनिकेशन प्रीवियसली रिमेंबर पोस्टपेड कंटिन्यूअस सर्विस इट इज. तो इट इज नॉट कॉल बाय कॉल सर्विस, कंटिन्यूअस नेचर का सर्विस. अब मैम इफ समथिंग इज कंटिन्यूअस नेचर का आइदर वी विल गेट अ बिल, यस, आइदर वी विल गेट दैट सक्सेसिव अकाउंट, आइदर दैट पर्सन विल बी पेइंग अस द अमाउंट, तो एटलीस्ट आइदर बिफोर रिसीविंग द पेमेंट और गिविंग द सक्सेसिव अकाउंट स्टेटमेंट और अस पर्टिकुलर इवेंट वी हैव डिसाइडेड. कैसे मैम? अगेन ये जो 10 days में वी हैव डन द क्लासेस, रिमेंबर वो कंस्ट्रक्शन वाला एग्जाम्पल, इज कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बिल्डिंग अ सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विस? तो वही वाला एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं. सपोज यू कम टू मी फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बिल्डिंग. सो दिस इज द बिल्डिंग दैट वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट. ये क्या है? बिल्डिंग दैट वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट. सो एज यू नो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दिस फैक्ट की this construction of building is what? Supply of service. Construction of building kya hai? Construction of building is nothing but supply of service. Now what terms we have agreed? Humne ek term pe agreement kiya. We have agreed on a term. Now what is the term? When this first floor will get completed, this ground floor, when this ground floor will get completed, you have to pay me how much? You have to pay me 25% amount. Then when this first floor, now this is the first floor, when this first floor will get completed, you have to pay me kitna? 33% amount. Similarly with this and these, we have agreed 50% you have to pay here and another 50% you would be paying here. So is it event based? When this event ground floor overall complete, pay me 25. When my first floor complete, pay me 33. When my second floor completed, pay me 50%. When finally done, pay me the remaining amount. So can I say continuous service it is? But this is event-based service. Ye kaun si event-based service hai? So in case of ma'am service, and that is a continuous service, so either it would be event-based. So on or before the completion of event, generate your invoice. On or before completion of event, generate your invoice. चलो मैम इट इज नॉट इवेंट बेस्ड. सपोज मैम बट वी हैव डिसाइडेड अ ड्यू डेट कि ऑन दिस डेट यू हैव टू पे मी द अमाउंट. आई एम वर्किंग फॉर यू एवरी फर्स्ट स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द फर्स्ट मंथ. दिस बिल्डिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन, ये जो बिल्डिंग हम कंस्ट्रक्ट कर रहे हैं, दिस कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बिल्डिंग विल टेक एटलीस्ट 7 months. एवरी मंथ ऑन फर्स्ट डे आई शुड गेट वॉट? इतना अमाउंट. द ड्यू डेट डिसाइडेड इज एवरी मंथ first date of every month I should get my amount. So have I decided the due date? So either on or before the due date, or is it is on or before the due date, or on or before that event, at least pay the amount na. On or before due date pay kar do ya event ke pehle. So in such a case invoice kab generate karoge? If event based to on or before that event. If due date based, on or before that due date, generate the invoice in case of continuous service. Ma'am, What if it is not a continuous service? That means you have given me a cloth. तुमने मुझे एक cloth दिया, बोला कि embroidery करके दे दो. Do the embroidery on that cloth. Is it continuous? नहीं. It is. You are giving me cloth. This is embroidery done. It is not a continuous supply of service. Ma'am, in such a case, what we should do? In such a case, check when is the completion done. When is the completion of service done? So, either before the completion of service, generate the invoice, or if the service already completed within 30 days from the completion, generate the invoice. Either before the completion of service, you can generate invoice, or already, ma'am, service completed within 30 days, you should generate the invoice. But in case of banking business and insurance business, this 30 days is 45 days. So they have given you ki what is the due date for generation of invoice, that is section number 31. Let us revise now. Ma'am, section number 31 was about due date of invoice. Due date of invoice is further divided into supply of goods or supply of service. Ma'am, supply of goods is further divided into normal supply and approval basis supply. Ma'am, approval basis supply, it is 6 months from the date of removal or time of supply, whichever is earlier. Ma'am, when it is my normal supply is continuous or other than continuous? Ma'am, other than continuous is further divided into movement and no movement. Ma'am, in case of movement, on or before the removal of that goods, and in case of no movement, on or before the delivery or making the goods available for delivery, you should generate invoice. Ma'am, it is continuous nature ka supply of goods. Continuous nature mein either you will be giving successive account statement or you would be receiving payment. So on or before either payment receipt date or on or before that successive account statement giving date, you should generate your invoice. That is for your goods. Now coming to service. Ma'am, in case of service, either continuous service or other than continuous service. Ma'am, if it is continuous service, so either due date is decided or event is decided, so on or before due date or on or before that event, you should generate invoice. Ma'am, it is not a continuous supply of service, so either before completion of the service or within 30 days from the completion of service, generate your invoice. Ma'am, but I am banking or insurance company. In such a case, after the completion of service, within 45 days, you should generate your invoice. Now, if you have a grip on this section number 31, then according to the situations of type of supply, your due date of invoice will change. Abhi samjho yahan pe. If you have a grip, very good grip on this section number 31, tabhi to I can say ki now they have simply given one thing. Choti si baat boli unhone, simply given one thing. That is, ma'am, under section 12, when it is supply of goods, either forward, either reverse. Ma'am, forward be normal mein. And remember, my normal is further divided into continuous and other than continuous. And my other than continuous is further divided into movement and no movement. Kya ye baat ko main fir se repeat karu? Ma'am, in case of goods, time of supply has been given. Now they are saying forward or reverse mechanism. Usko abhi abhi ignore karte. But they have said forward in normal charge. Ma'am, forward, normal charge. Forward under normal, and ma'am, my normal, if I take this normal supply divided into continuous other than continuous, then other than continuous further divided. That means depending on your type of question, understand ki due date of invoice ka kaun sa formula you have to use. Are you getting? Ki tumhara type of question tumhe ye batayega ki due date of invoice kaun si honi chahiye. Then you will able to apply time of supply ka concept in respect of goods or service as the case may be. Abhi samajh mein aaya? Recall kar lo pehle section 31, then only we will move to time of supply of goods and service. That period, first of all, acche se properly you recall that. And that is the reason I am saying PDF ko use mat karna when you are doing by your own. Reason kya? अगर तुम पीडीएफ यूज कर करके बार बार पढ़ोगे तो कभी भी वो यहाँ नहीं आने वाला. एंड एट द टाइम ऑफ एग्जाम यू विल बी वेस्टिंग योर 1 आवर एटलीस्ट टू अगेन लर्न दिस टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई का कॉन्सेप्ट. देयरफॉर यू शुड मेक अ टेबल एंड यू शुड स्टिक इट वेयर यू आर स्टडिंग बिकॉज दिस नीड मल्टीपल रिविजन टू गेट इन टू योर हेड. ठीक है, इजी चैप्टर Now only 2 pages ka chapter is left, but that concept, to learn that concept and to have a long term memory about the concept, usko tumhe recalling karna padega, re-reading nahi karna. Okay, chalo, giving you 3-4 minutes, acche se learn it properly. Learn is as if after class tumko learn nahi karna hai, acche se learn karo. Done.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, other than continuous supply, that completion from completion, yes or no point, can you please tell, ma'am?
Other than
continuous supply in case of
understood. In case of service, you are asking, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Suppose I have completed the service, whatever service it is, you have given me the cloth for embroidery. Either when you have come, hey, ma'am, I want embroidery on my dress. I should give you before completion of my service, this would be the invoice. Now, I have already completed that embroidery. That means service got completed. At least after completion, within 30 days from the completion, you should give the invoice to that person. Ki dekho bhai, tumhara service complete ho gaya, and within 30 days, generate the invoice. So that is completion. You also call it provision of service. Instead of completion, what ICI use? Provision of service. That means completion of service. Theek hai? Now, इसको भी विथ फुल अटेंशन यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड नॉट मोर मच ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग नाउ बट लर्निंग इज इम्पॉर्टेंट नाउ. अब वो बोलता है कि मैम नाउ वी आर फाइनली ऑन टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई एंड टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई हैज ओनली टू सेक्शन, सेक्शन नंबर 12 एंड 13, 12 इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू गुड्स एंड 13 इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू सर्विस. डन. मैम गुड्स में भी फॉरवर्ड चार्ज रिवर्स चार्ज, सर्विस में भी वी हैव अंडरस्टूड देयर इज फॉरवर्ड एज वेल एज रिवर्स चार्ज मैकेनिज्म. तो वेदर इट इज योर गुड्स फॉरवर्ड रिवर्स, वेदर इट इज योर सर्विस फॉरवर्ड रिवर्स मैकेनिज्म एप्लीकेबल ऑन बोथ. नाउ मैम व्हेन इट इज फॉरवर्ड चार्ज मैकेनिज्म आइदर नॉर्मल सप्लाई और कंपोजिशन सप्लाई, मैम आइदर नॉर्मल सप्लाई और कंपोजिशन सप्लाई. मैम ये नॉर्मल क्या है और ये कंपोजिशन क्या है, वॉट इज दिस? So they are talking about the person here. Either the person who is registered under normal mechanism, he is doing the forward supply, or the person who is registered under composition scheme, he is doing the supply. What is composition scheme? Can we go into the detail? No, we cannot go into the detail of composition scheme. Why, ma'am? Because with registration chapter, you will find types of registration. See, actually, ICI has not given this kind of cluster that I have made cluster for the purpose of better understanding. When you go for registration, it could be normal registration. It could be composition scheme wala registration. It could be voluntary registration. And my registration is further divided into compulsory registration also. So there are certain types of registration also. So when we will be doing that registration chapter, then we will do all the types of registration together. Abhi ma'am, composition kya? Composition means suppose a pani puri wala bhaiya. Theek hai? Suppose a pani puri wala bhaiya, turnover to bahut hai. He is having a very good turnover. You also don't know. Ab to aajkal really chal rahi kitni sari. Ki that MBA chai wala, that your momos wala bhaiya, they are earning more than us. Per day they are earning 3000. So from that, are you understanding? Turnover to is good. Now, suppose for an example, imaginary, pani puri wala bhaiya has an accountant there. Usko ab kya karna hai? Accountant rakhna hai. Why, ma'am? He is earning a good amount. 30-40 lakh to he is earning. Normally 30-40 lakh he is earning. Ma'am, 40 lakh mein to threshold limit cross. Registration ke liye you have 10 lakh as a limit, 20 lakh as a limit, 40 lakh as a limit. Can't go in the detail. That depends state-wise and condition-wise. But if, suppose, ab hamare liye applicable, for me applicable is 40 lakh ka threshold. My 40 lakh crossed. So, yahan pe bolte ma'am, that pani puri wala bhaiya, uske liye 40 lakh threshold was applicable. Suppose all the terms and condition fulfilled. Uske liye limit kitni hai? 40 lakh. Cross ho gaya. Ma'am, in such a case, pani puri wala bhaiya should get registered. He should have an accountant for tax invoices. You are getting 20 rupees ka pani puri plus GST itna. Are you getting? Uske liye kitna mushkil ho jayega bhai ke liye? Ma'am, pani puri ka ek hi plate chahiye. 10 rupees ka pani puri ka plate, GST itna. That means a person is sitting there who is making tax invoice in case of panipuri. Are you getting the difficulty that kind of person will be facing? Ma'am, tea, ek cut dena, aadha cut dena, chai ka karte na tum, aadha cut, ek cut. In that also, someone is sitting and applying GST. Ek to accountant, chalo accountant bhi rakh liya. Now the person who is registered under normal charge, every month return file karna usko. Every month, or not only one return, you know, GST mein ek return nahi hai. Three returns per month he has to file. तो मतलब पानीपुरी वाला भैया थ्री रिटर्न्स पर मंथ उसको एक सीए की जरूरत है. नाउ ही नीड्स अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट हु विल बी डूइंग ऑल दिस जीएसटी का वर्किंग फॉर हिम. देन जीएसटी ऑडिट माइट बी एप्लीकेबल, वो लेटर ऑन वी विल डिस्कस. बट आर यू गेटिंग प्रैक्टिकल डिफिकल्टी? ठेले वाला भैया हु इज अर्निंग 45 लाख 50 लाख, नाउ ही नीड्स एन अकाउंटेंट, ही नीड्स एवरी मंथ थ्री रिटर्न्स उसको फाइल करने हैं. एंड सपोज दैट ठेले वाला पानीपुरी भैया रिमोट लोकेशन पे गाँव में in the villages, and ma'am usko village se he should come to where city for all this, ye sare compliance karne ke liye kisi city mein hi CA ke paas aana padega. Matlab out of one month at least 7 days he will be traveling. Why 7 days ma'am? CA ek baar mein kaam karte hai kya? This document is missing, that is missing, this is not correct, that is not correct. Matlab ek pani puri wala bhaiya will change the business. Are you getting the practical difficulty? वो प्रैक्टिकल डिफिकल्टी को रूट आउट करने के लिए फॉर ऑल दिस सच काइंड ऑफ पीपल दे हैव गिवन अ कंपोजिशन स्कीम कि इफ यू हैव 1 करोड़ का टर्नओवर, यू वांट टू गेट रजिस्टर्ड, यू हैव टू गेट रजिस्टर्ड, बट नॉट अंडर नॉर्मल चार्ज. इट इज ऑप्शन फॉर यू, यू मे गेट रजिस्टर्ड अंडर कंपोजिशन स्कीम. अंडर कंपोजिशन स्कीम क्वार्टरली रिटर्न इज टू बी फाइल्ड. There are many relaxation given in composition scheme, quarterly return, TDS, that taxes you don't have to collect. बहुत सारी चीजें हैं, leave it there. But are you getting composition is to give facility. So either you would be registered on a normal or it would be composition scheme. Either normal or it would be what? Composition scheme. So ma'am, when it comes to time of supply in respect of goods, when it comes to time of supply in respect of goods, that too, ma'am, forward charge mechanism. If I talk about a normal person, check invoice or due date of invoice. Check invoice or due date of invoice. Ma'am, actually the invoice generated on 15th July. But due date of invoice after applying section 31, jo abhi humne kiya. Ma'am, due date was actually coming to be 12th July. But he has generated invoice on 15th July. So, ma'am, whatever is earlier, due date is earlier. So your time of supply is 12th July for taxable event happened, and from 12th July you are liable to pay GST. Ma'am, your due date differ karega. Obviously, due date differ whether it is continuous, not continuous, approval basis. That basis pe you will decide ki kaun sa due date you will be using, and that will be told by question. So again, ma'am, in respect of goods, if it is forward charge and under normal person, invoice or due date of invoice. Ma'am, but what about this composition wala person? Invoice or due date of invoice, that is same. But for composition wala person, if he receives payment, so date of payment or due date of invoice or invoice, whichever is earlier. Ma'am, first of all, when it is normal, invoice or due date of invoice? Ma'am, it is not normal, composition, invoice, due date of invoice or payment, date of payment, whichever is earlier. So, register one thing, man, in case of goods, when it is normal, in case of normal, invoice or due date of invoice, ma'am, it is composition same, but ek add kya ho gaya? Date of payment, whichever is earlier. So, are you getting time of supply ka kuch khud ka relevance nahi hai until you know section number 31, that is due date of invoice, until you know there is no relevance. Are you getting that? इतना समझ में आया मैम. अब आई एम गिविंग यू अ क्वेश्चन. सपोज मिस्टर ए सप्लाइज गुड. मिस्टर ए हु इज रजिस्टर्ड अंडर नॉर्मल मैकेनिज्म. मिस्टर ए रजिस्टर्ड अंडर नॉर्मल मैकेनिज्म प्रोवाइड्स गुड्स टू मिस्टर बी ऑन अप्रूवल बेसिस. व्हाट विल बी द टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई? What will be the time of supply? I am not asking what will be the due date of invoice. मिस्टर ए, ठीक है. सो मिस्टर ए रिमूव द गुड्स फॉर मिस्टर बी. ठीक है, सपोज ही रिमूव द गुड्स ऑन फर्स्ट अप्रैल. फर्स्ट अप्रैल को ही रिमूव द गुड्स. नाउ टेल मी, एंड एक्चुअल इनवॉइस वगैरह का भी मैं कुछ नहीं दे रही, जस्ट आई वॉन्ट टू नो कि वॉट यू विल डू, वॉट विल बी द टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई. इग्नोर दिस डेट, अभी इग्नोर कर दो. जस्ट मिस्टर ए रिमूव द गुड्स फॉर मिस्टर बी, वॉट इज टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई. तो मैम नॉर्मल में ही इज रजिस्टर्ड, यस. टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई यू आर आस्किंग, एंड इन केस ऑफ नॉर्मल रूल सेज इनवॉइस और ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस, राइट. रूल क्या बोलता है, इनवॉइस और ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस. मैम माई ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस इज गिवन इन सेक्शन नंबर 31, एंड ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस क्या बोलता है, 6 months फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ रिमूवल और टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई विच एवर इज अर्लियर. दैट मीन्स इसके लिए आई हैव टू अप्लाई सेक्शन नंबर 31, देन आई विल कंपेयर इनवॉइस और ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस विच एवर इज अर्लियर. इतनी बात समझ में, फिर हम एग्जाम्पल्स को डेट के वाइज देखेंगे. वो चीज समझ में आई कि इनकॉर्पोरेट ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस सेक्शन 31. डन. अभी मैम व्हेन इट इज कंपोजिशन इनवॉइस ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस डेट ऑफ पेमेंट विच एवर इज अर्लियर. मैम अब ये डेट ऑफ पेमेंट क्या है, अब उसको भी यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज डेट ऑफ पेमेंट. तो मैम डेट ऑफ पेमेंट की अगर हम बात करें तो डेट ऑफ पेमेंट गिवन हियर, डेट ऑफ पेमेंट इन द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट, व्हेन यू राइट कि आई एम गिविंग दिस पेमेंट टू दिस पर्सन ऑन 21 ऑफ दिसंबर, बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट में यू हैव रिटर्न की डेट ऑफ पेमेंट इन योर बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट. और व्हेन इट गेट क्रेडिटेड टू योर बैंक अकाउंट, आइदर द डेट ऑफ पेमेंट इन गुड्स ऑफ अकाउंट. सपोज मैंने सेल किया, आई एम द पर्सन हु इज सेलिंग टू यू, यू हैव गिवन मी द अमाउंट, यू हैव गिवन मी द अमाउंट. बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट में आई एम राइटिंग ऑन 21st ऑफ दिसंबर, लक्ष्मी हैज गिवन मी दिस अमाउंट. बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट में आई एम राइटिंग द डेट. और द डेट इट गेट क्रेडिटेड इन माई बैंक अकाउंट. अब समझो, सपोज ऑन 19 दिसंबर फंड ट्रांसफर टू माई अकाउंट, बट सपोज इट इज चेक के थ्रू ट्रांसफर. चेक क्लियरेंस विल टेक 2 days. 2 days हो गए, चेक ऑलरेडी गॉट क्लियर्ड इन माई अकाउंट. कब हुआ, 19 को यू हैव गिवन मी चेक, 2021 को चेक क्लियर. तो क्रेडिट इन माई बैंक अकाउंट इज ऑन 21st ऑफ दिसंबर, राइट. इतना समझ में आया कि 21st दिसंबर को इट गॉट क्रेडिटेड इन माई अकाउंट. नाउ ऑन 25th दिसंबर इट इज हॉलीडे, नाउ आई एम राइटिंग इन माई बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट की 25th दिसंबर को कि दिस अमाउंट आई गॉट. सो आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग, विच एवर इज अर्लियर ही देखना है कि आइदर क्रेडिट. Or when you write in your books of account, when you write in your books of account ki that amount received, or with it, actually it got credited. Earlier kya hai? That earlier is the date of payment. Ma'am, phir ye earlier is the date of payment. Isko hum kahan incorporate karenge? Ye date of payment hai. Then we will start comparing all these three. Tab jaake samajh mein aayega ki what is the time of supply. मतलब मैम इन केस ऑफ टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई सेक्शन नंबर 31 के अकॉर्डिंग विच एवर इज अर्लियर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू सी व्हाट इज ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस. देन व्हेन इट इज डेट ऑफ पेमेंट, उसके लिए भी वी हैव टू सी कि व्हेन वी राइट इन आवर बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट और व्हेन इट इज एक्चुअली गॉट क्रेडिटेड इन माई बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट, विच एवर इज अर्लियर. वो मुझे बताएगा डेट ऑफ पेमेंट क्या है, देन वी विल कंपेयर इनवॉइस ड्यू डेट ऑफ इनवॉइस डेट ऑफ पेमेंट विच एवर इज अर्लियर, फिर जाके पता चलेगा टाइम ऑफ सप्लाई क्या है. अंडरस्टूड? अभी ऐसा लग रहा है मैम इतना करना है, बट वंस यू लर्न दिस क्वेश्चन में इजिली यू विल आइडेंटिफाई कि दिस इज द केस, कंटिन्यूस नॉट कंटिन्यूस नॉर्मल कंपोजिशन एंड विच फॉर्मूला यू हैव टू अप्लाई. बिकॉज वंस यू लर्न दिस फॉर्मूला, तो if you learn which formula, once you learn this formula, automatically you will know na ki what invoice due date or invoice ka kaun sa formula apply karoge, and date of payment ka to formula always same. So basically learn kya karna hai, that section number 31 you have to learn. Are you getting? So I don't prefer isse aage badhu aaj main, yehi abhi bahut ho gaya hai. मन में तो क्या है मुझे पता है, फिर भी बोल लो एक बार.
यू कैन मैम.
हाँ हाँ मैम.
कैन आई कंटिन्यू?
कंटिन्यू गुड्स.
नहीं, जो अंदर से लग रहा है ना वो बाहर लेके आओ. जो सच्चाई है उसको एक्सेप्ट करो कि कैन यू बियर इट मोर. राजेश जी इज लाइक, अरे आज की मोटिवेशन भी मत जाओ, सच्चाई भी बोलो. करके दिखाएंगे, ऐसा भी करके मत दिखा दो. कैन आई कंटिन्यू? कोई तुम लोग पता कैसे कर रही हूँ, हंस रहे हो, बोलना तो चाहते हैं पर सच्ची बोलो रे. टेल मी ऑनेस्टली, शुड आई कंटिन्यू? अरे बोलो.
यस मैम.
मैम ओनली गुड सेक्शन वी कैन कंप्लीट.
ओनली गुड सेक्शन वी कैन कंप्लीट एंड सर्विस वी विल कंप्लीट लेटर ऑन. पता है ना मुझे. सो ओनली गुड सेक्शन वी विल कंप्लीट. यस.
जो डेट ऑफ पेमेंट इन बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स और डेट ऑफ पेमेंट क्रेडिट इन बोथ आर पॉइंट ऑफ सैलरी.
Date of payment in books of account. Suppose you have given me payment on 19 December. Check दिया. So can I write check received on 19 December in my books of account? But वो check कब credit होगा? Obviously 2-3 days तो लगेंगे. So suppose that credited on when? It credited on 21st of December. But date of payment तो whichever is earlier रहेगा. Point number one. Flip करते हैं. Suppose you have given me the check. तुमने मुझे check दिया. When you have given me the check? You have actually given me check on 19 December, but my policy is until the amount gets credited to my account, I will not write in my books of account. So, ab ulta ho gaya ki credit hua 21st December ko, but when I will write in my books of account, 25th it is holiday. Now I am maintaining the books of account. Aur maine likh diya ki this is 25th December. Yes, actual payment received. So, books of account ki entry differ kar sakti hai na? Either जैसे ही चेक रिसीव हुआ यू आर राइटिंग, या फिर तुम बोलते एक बार क्लियर हो गए तो फिर बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट मेंटेन करेंगे. सो इट डिपेंड्स व्हिच एवर इज अर्लियर चेंज हो जाएगा. अंडरस्टूड?
मींस बोथ हर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ सप्लायर.
हां, बट तुम्हें ये मैंने प्रैक्टिकली बताया. इन योर एग्जाम दे विल डायरेक्टली गिव यू डेट कि क्रेडिट डेट ये है, बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट की डेट इज दिस. यू हैव टू जस्ट कंपेयर व्हिच एवर इज अर्लियर. ठीक है. नाउ लास्ट, that is reverse charge mechanism in case of goods. Ma'am, reverse charge mechanism in case of goods. Again, can I say payment? Yes, ma'am. Can I say date of issue of invoice, date of receipt of goods or payment or date of issue of invoice 31st day? Ab ye bhi thoda sa samajhne wali baat hai. Ma'am, if it is reverse charge mechanism, why you have written date of receipt? Because in reverse charge mechanism, recipient is doing all the compliances. तो पता तो चले actual में उसको receive हुआ या नहीं हुआ goods. तो in case of reverse charge mechanism, recipient is the one who will do all the compliance. He will be paying the taxes. तो at least receipt तो होना चाहिए उसको goods. तो we want date of receipt of goods. Ma'am, then we will generate invoice. बट दे से इन केस ऑफ रिवर्स चार्ज मैकेनिज्म. देखो मैं रिवर्स चार्ज मैकेनिज्म अभी क्रक्स ही बता रही हूँ. वाई? बिकॉज दैट 30 डेज का लॉजिक आई हैव टू गिव एंड दैट 30 डेज का लॉजिक इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन योर ITC. आई विल नॉट गो इन टू डिटेल टूडे. पॉसिबल नहीं हो मैं खुद बोल रही हूँ. बट रिमेंबर दिस इज जस्ट डायरेक्ट आई एम टेलिंग यू कि इफ रिवर्स चार्ज मैकेनिज्म में रिसिपिएंट इज देयर एंड रिसिपिएंट इज डूइंग ऑल द कंप्लायंसेस, तो रिसिप्ट तो होना चाहिए ना उसको गुड्स. He should receive the goods, so I will see date of receipt of goods. Ma'am, invoice he has generated, so we will wait for 30 days. यहाँ पे क्या लिखा है? He has generated the invoice. Already invoice is generated. We will wait for 30 days. After 31st day, that is your supply done. Supply is done. अब इसको I have to explain. I cannot say कि बस ऐसे 31st day and it is done. This will take my 10 minutes to explain. Therefore, ये 31st day का logic we are not taking right now. So, in case of ma'am time of supply, as you are saying, we need date of receipt, yes. फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ इश्यू ऑफ इनवॉइस वी विल वेट फॉर 30 डेज एंड जैसे ही 30 डेज खत्म हुआ फ्रॉम 31st डे दिस इज योर सप्लाई. 2, 3 वी विल चेक पेमेंट. व्हेन पेमेंट इज डन आइदर डेट ऑफ रिसिप्ट आइदर व्हेन आई एम डूइंग द पेमेंट मैम पेमेंट 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 अगेन यू हैव टू डिस्कस पेमेंट ओवर है. इसमें भी पेमेंट भी डिस्कस करना है बिकॉज रिवर्स चार्ज मैकेनिज्म में दिस इज नॉट द डेट ऑफ पेमेंट. Reverse charge mechanism is this is the date of payment. So are you getting? Again, thoda sa detail is there. So let us stop it forward only. Nahi to bahut sari cheeze gadbad ho jayegi. We can spend 2 days on time of supply. That is okay. But iska what is the target for you today? First of all, without even checking my chart, without having even seeing what is written in PDF, section 31 you have to write. And you have to write time of supply with respect of goods in case of normal and composition forward mechanism. Sirf utna likh ke you have to send me the PDF. Theek hai? Done? So tomorrow we will be taking revision. Subah in the morning it would be revision. And Karthik Naidu, you have to compulsory attend that class. Why? Because that is starting from December 5th what we have done. We will be revising everything tomorrow. So first of all, what we will revise supply. Supply ka all the linkages, okay? That we will revise. And we will revise place of supply. I don't think time of supply we can revise now because yet not completed. So whatever we have done till now, we will be revising tomorrow. So timing is same, 6:15, okay? And in DT, as you know, again, DT maybe we will be revising everything that we have done till now. Okay? Chalo. Okay.